doing something in our friend's memory, then I want to give him that respect to listen about him. Even though we are talking about Diwali, Diwali is great, that's fine. Good over evil, who knows, if there was no evil, there would have been no good. Light over dark, if there was no dark, light would have no value. So they equally are important. So we all are smart enough, so let's not abuse the dark as much as we want to abuse the, give the glory to the light. So, I was saying when supervisor walk in, supervisor, yes, he's a supervisor of our town. To me, he's my friend. Was, is, will be. No matter what. Because there's no conditions when it comes to friendship. And that's where I always say, your friendship humble me. I know a little older, I'm older than you a little bit. I met this young man when he worked for Town of Hempstead. Then I met this young man, I still remember as clearly, not in the political process, but on the second floor of the Town of Oyster Bay in the building departments. I went to help someone who needed a help. It wasn't his department. He sees me and he say, Bobby, what I can do for you? I say, it's not for me. It is these people need a help. I learned later on he was busy to go attend to do what he's supposed to do. I'm sure he probably got abused while he was late, but he took his time to help the person who needed a help. Of course, I loved the young man as a friend, but that day he went way above in my own thought process. Yes, he got elected 7 terms to the assembly when the town of Oyster Bay was going through. I can't even describe you the challenge. Was known corrupt, bad, negative, all negative perception. Nobody in their right mind would say, I want to leave this town. We know so many people in the party, both sides, who said, not now. Even they all wanted it. Joe Saladino could have stayed in assembly and be a leader in the assembly on different level. He chose, give up the leadership, come to the town, fight, where by the way, he was very secure, unquestionably getting elected year after year. He gave up that. I'm trying to share his character of humanity and friendship. What he do? He agreed. Some of his close friends, including me, we thought something wrong with him, that he's agreeing. But he loved the town and the people so much, he said, I will bring the town out of this negativity. I will stand up for the town. I stand up for the people. And yo, thank you so much for your trust, respect, and what you do. And you know, I'm not just saying nice things because he's standing here. I'm saying it is the right thing to do. And the reason I share this, I'm going to come back to Peter Bedaji. And thank you allowing me for a couple extra minutes because that's one of the reasons we are here. I shared with the supervisor back in my office, Gene, I met you also because of Peter. I remember the last event when he introduced me to you. Even though I met you many times, but I remember the last one more specifically. and it was right next to a gentleman who won the Nobel Peace Prize, doctor, I forget his last name. We were standing together, and Laura couldn't join us. Peter that I know, when I did not spoke English, I hardly spoke English. The people from, specifically from my state, they didn't care much about me, including Dr. Mrs. Neil Bennett. Just kidding. Because it's not their fault. Because they used to a class, different class system. It's not their fault. If I was in that situation, I would be the same. Sunil is very few people who actually, because we spoke the same language, but just to talk to me. Most people won't. But when come to Peter Beda, Shivash Kapadia, Uncle Das, Ajit Modi, they unconditionally given me the love and respect as boy from the small village. So I never ask anybody to help my charity, which is called Friends for Good Health. And the reason I'm sharing this, since I never ask anybody to help me, we did it what we could afford to do ourselves. And thanks to Kenny, thanks to Violeta, I can say thanks to Jay and Indu. Indu, you're not going anywhere. Please sit down for a minute. I'm talking about your very special friend. And Sudhir going nowhere. He going next Sunday to Florida, not today. So, Peter is the only one that I know in my 40-year charitable work or political work that I did not ask. He grabbed me one day. He said, you know, you're doing so much charitable work. Bobby, I want to help you. I said, Peterji, but we never ask anyone for help. He said, that's why I want to. Because what you're doing, most people don't know. It wasn't me doing. It is us who was doing. A Peter, really. A leader, honesty, decency, and caring about others was unquestionable. He did not question me. Only time he drove me crazy, he said, did you get, how come you didn't cash my check yet? How come you didn't cash the check yet? I forgot that I lost the check. So I, Peterji, I lost the check. And this is the truth. That day he did not went to sleep till he made sure the money is transferred to my account that he pledged. So please accept my thank you on behalf of my friend and your friend and what you're doing, a real friend, and that's my friend and your friend, Peter Bidaji. It's an honor for me to say in the presence of Dorothy and your daughter, the man, I don't know how many people can explain that way. And I thank you. And Supervisor, it is my double honor to share one friend with the other in a manners. You see how peaceful all my elders listen to me, and I thank you so much.